On the left, Khalifa Haftar. On the right, Fayez al-Sarraj. Two bitter rivals brought together in Paris. The 74-year-old Field Marshal Haftar is the strongman of eastern Libya. In 1969, he took part in the coup that brought Muammar Gaddafi to power. A split with the dictator saw him exiled to America, but he returned in 2011 to take part in the uprising that would topple Gaddafi. Commander-in-chief of the Libyan National Army, today he has tens of thousands of soldiers under him. Since 2016, he's controlled five of the country's six principal oil terminals, 85% of Libya's reserves. He's racked up military gains and liberated Benghazi from jihadis, including the Islamic State group. Several weeks ago, he announced the start of the final battle for Derna, also in the hands of Islamist militants.
On this holiday, we proclaim that zero hour for the liberation of Derna has arrived.
Haftar has the support, open or tacit, of several Gulf states, the US, and France. But officially, according to the international community and the UN, Libya's true leader is Fayez al-Sarraj, head of the interim government of National Accord in Tripoli. Since his nomination just over a year ago, he's made it his mission to reconcile the country and pacify the capital.
We want to find common ground between all parties to the conflict and put an end to the suffering. We need to implement all initiatives for this objective.
A year ago, al-Sarraj had hoped to be able to organize presidential and legislative elections by spring 2018. Those elections, now scheduled for December.